We are now in week seven, and you do have a test for this Thursday. It's going to be on chapter three, and so let's take a look. Also, next week, or week eight, there will be a sign-up sheet for you to sign up for a retest, and then in week nine, on a Wednesday, you will take a retest. Now, remember that you must make your corrections, and you must get a signature, and it's for better or worse. All right, so let's take a look here. I want area and perimeter. Well, this is a parallelogram right here. So the area of a parallelogram is base times height. So the base, if you color in this box and follow it over to here, your base is 4 and your height is 7. So it's 4 times 7 is 28 square inches. To find perimeter, you add up 8 plus 8, or 8 times 2, because you have 2 of them, and then 2 times 4, because you have 2 of the 4s, or 8 plus 8 plus 4 plus 4, if you want to. So this is 16 plus 8, and that should be 24 inches. Okay, remember, perimeter is one dimension, area is 2, and volume is 3 dimension. And we're not on volume yet. All right, so let's go on. The next one is a trapezoid. You see the parallel sides? I would go ahead and turn it to where the parallel sides were on top and bottom. So the formula for a trapezoid, or area of a trapezoid, is 1/2 the height. We'll color this box in, and one of these is your base and one's your height, okay? But this is actually your height right here, from base to base. So put 6.5, and then add up your bases, which are 7 and 12. Okay, now I want you to do parentheses first. So that's going to be 19 times 6.5. So clear out your calculator. 19 times 6.5, press equals, and then divide by 2. Remember, if it begins with a T, like triangle or trapezoid, you must divide by 2 at the very end, is where I want you to. Okay, so this is going to be square units, whatever it is, inches, feet. Perimeter, however, you would add up the sides. Do not add up 6.5 because that's not the side. So you're going to do 6, 7, and 5 plus 12, and whatever you get will be your perimeter, and this would be in units to the first power. This right here is 13 and 5 is 18, and 18 and 12 is going to give you 30, I think that is. Okay. All right, the next one is an obtuse triangle, okay? Now, to do an obtuse triangle, the area of the triangle is going to be 1/2 the base times the height. Well, color your box in, okay? I want to see those boxes colored. So one of these is your height and one's your base. Well, your height is 5. And your base is going to be 4. So 4 times 5 is 20, and then half of 20 is 10 square inches. Okay, make sure you color that box in. To find perimeter, you're going to add up the sides. Do not add up that 5, because that's only the height of the triangle. So you're going to add up 10, 6, and 4. So this is 10 plus 10 more makes 20. So it's going to be 20 inches to the first power. All right, on a new sheet of paper, you want to copy down these formulas and make sure you memorize them for your test. Please do not write them on my desk, and do not write them on your hand or anywhere else. You must try to memorize them. All right, let's go on. Today, we're doing the last section of this chapter, which is why we're having a test. And I decided to put it off till Thursday to give you a little more practice. So take a look up here. I want you to draw number one, and I'll make it a little bigger for you. Okay, so draw that first diagram. And what we're going to do is perimeter and area. So what we're going to do now is find perimeter. So let's do that first because that's easier. So the perimeter is going to be 8 plus 8 plus 7 plus 12 plus 7. You're going to add all that up and get your perimeter. Well, this right here is 20 between those two. So it's going to be 20 right there. between those two. This is 14 and 8, I think, is 22. And we're going to get 42 inches for perimeter. To find area, this is called a composite. You have a rectangle plus the top part is a triangle. It's called a composite. It's two diagrams. So the rectangle is right here. So that's going to be length times width. So 12 times 7, length times width. The triangle is 1/2 the base times the height. So it's 1/2 the base. The base here is 12, and you can bring that 12 to the top. Okay, we're looking only at the triangle now. So put a 12 right there. Move it up. So you're going to have the base is 12 and the height is 2. And so the area of this thing will be 7 times 2 is 14, carry my 1, 7, 8, that looks like 84. This right here is 24, and then half of 24 is 12. And then you're going to add that up and get 96 square units. So you have perimeter and area. Remember, in perimeter, you don't add the 2, and you don't add that 12. You just add the sides. That's called perimeter. It's the exterior or distance around an object. Okay? And then to do the composite area, you have a rectangle and a triangle. All right, the next one is the same way. You have a rectangle and a triangle. And I would say this one would be my height. So you're going to split that up. You might want to turn it like that. So you're going to have a rectangle and a triangle. This one right here, when you get to this one, it looks kind of weird, but draw this straight down and you have two trapezoids. So you have 1/2 the height times the sum of the two bases here, and then this is the same way. And notice that this is a base. Base 1, base 2, base 3. The bases are the ones that are parallel. So this one would be parallel to that one, and then this one is parallel to the other two. And those are your bases. The other ones are called legs of the trapezoid. So you have two trapezoids on that one. It's not that big of a deal. This one right here is the tomahawk, let's say. And basically, you're going to divide it here, and you're going to make a trapezoid, and you're going to make a rectangle. So it's a composite figure. This one right here, the number one, you can divide it a lot of different ways. One way I would do it is like this. I would make a trapezoid here, 1/2 the height times the sum of the bases. And then you can draw this like this and make a rectangle here and make a rectangle here. And I want area and perimeter on all the diagrams regardless of what the directions say. So for today, I want you to do 3.5 in the workbook. And I think it's only like 5 problems. I do want you to draw, it's actually 6. So 1 through 6, and I want you to draw the diagrams or sketch them. If you do not draw the diagrams, you will not get credit. And I'm going to write that on the homework board in the front. All right, I hope you had a good morning, and I hope you understood the lesson. Make sure you memorize those formulas, and good luck on your test this Thursday. Wednesday will be a practice test. All right, so get started, and let's get this done.